Psalms chapter 32, verse 1. Blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sins are covered. Blessed is the man unto whom the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shah imputeth not iniquity, and whose spirit there is no guile. Let's read that verse again. Blessed is the man unto whom the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shah imputeth not iniquity, and in whose spirit there is no guile. And Salakit, when I kept silence, my bones waxed old through the roaring all the day long. For day and night thy hands were heavy upon me. My moisture is turned unto drought of the summer. Salah. I acknowledge my sin unto thee, and my iniquities have I not hid. I said, I will confess my transgression unto the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shah, and thou forgavest the iniquities of my sins. Salah. For this shall everyone that is godly pray unto thee in a time when thou mayest be found. Surely in the flood of a great water thou shalt not come nigh unto him. I'd like to give all prayers and honor and glory to Yahweh Shemel Shah, the Wadi Yahweh Shemel Shah, for giving us the apostles and the elders a great millstone who deserve double honors, rightfully so. And shout out to the Akim, pushing the word in sincerity and truth and being faith-based and being prepared for what is to come. And what is to come? Race wars, concentration camps, famine. The RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast. Thermonuclear fire, 200 million missiles being shot at the soldiers of America. Simultaneously, the chariots of the Lord lifting up the hopeful elect and preserving them for righteousness. You know, and simultaneously, the chariots of the Lord shooting laser beams at the ungodly. Rightfully so. I didn't know where I was going with this, but I was going through scriptures and this stuck out to me, and I just wanted to read it out, and I'm gonna try to break down a couple of words in each verse, and hopefully it'll be edifying. I'll wrap this up. I mean, today's the Day of Atonement, and we gotta afflict our soul. Well, we can't feed our body, we gotta feed our spirit. We got to go through this until this is over. You know? In this world, you're not perfect. But you do this to the best of your ability to be perfect. And that's what you... To even have the ability to endure. That is a gift, too. To endure this is a gift. You just can't... You just ain't going to get this overnight. Nobody, it's proven when you look at other people. They don't get it. You tell you when you say a couple of things to them, they get offended. You know? So everybody it's not for everybody. Alright, let me read this stuff on top again. Salaki. Psalm chapter 32, verse 1. Blessed is he whom transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Right. Because that is a blessing. See, that's another gift. All the shit you did in your life in this fucking filthy ass place, you feel ashamed about it, don't you? But that's a blessing that the Lord has forgiven you, and he had brought you into the fold of understanding his truth. He blessed you. Now you know not to do it again. You can't go back to that world. So you're blessed, and your sin is covered. Through the how your sin is covered? Through the blood of Yahweh Shemel, of Yahweh Shah. Okay? Blessed is the man unto whom the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shah imputeth not iniquity. I went into this word before, This is H. This is imputed. H2803. Kashab, right? All right. To think, plain, esteem, calculate, invent, make a judgment, imagine, count, to think, account, to plan, device, means, to change, to charge, to impute, to reckon, to esteem, to value, regard. So the Lord, he didn't count you. Your sins is not counted to him. So let's read that verse again. All right. So all the things you have done, the Lord, he put it to the side. All he wants you to do is work. Blessed is the man unto whom the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shah imputed not iniquity. He didn't count your iniquity. He said, all right, listen, you do exactly what I want, you ain't gotta worry about what you did. Make it good. All right. And whose spirit there is no, and in whose spirit there is no guile. All right. So he didn't count your iniquities. He didn't reckon. All right, listen. You did all this. Remember, you did this. No, he told you to put your thoughts into the Lord, to give all your burdens to him, and he would let you, if you ride for him and do exactly what he wants you to do, he ain't gonna worry. You ain't gonna worry about that. There ain't gonna be no guile in you. Okay. Okay. So all your iniquities has been purged out of you. But there's no going back. Alright? When I kept silence, my bones was waxed old, my roaring all the day long. For day and night thy hand were heavy upon me. My moisture is turned into drought of the summer, Salah. I acknowledge my sins unto thee. My iniquities have I not hid. That's right. You tell your, you put the burden to, you pray to the Lord so he can forgive you. Because Yahweh Shemel Shah is set up judges on the earth that could judge you. And that's how you learn what you did wrong. Dang, I can't, that's that, you know, you have sex with somebody else's woman, you eat unlawful food, and you realize these things are not right to do. You don't know the high holy days, you've been breaking all these years before you even knew the truth, you've been breaking all these laws. Now you learn the laws, you learn certain high holy days you're supposed to follow, and now, what are you supposed to do? Follow them to the best of your ability. Listen, you can't keep all the 613 laws. It's impossible in this wicked society. That's why the most important law you're supposed to follow is faith in Yahweh Shah. Yahweh Shemel Shah. I acknowledge my sin unto thee, and my iniquities have I not hid. I said, I will confess my transgression unto thee, Yahweh Shemel Shah. And thou forgavest the iniquities of my sin, Salah. And that's what you do. You pray to the Lord and you move on. You say, Lord, Salakia, if you can forgive me and let me keep on enduring for you. And that's a gift. To endure for Yahweh Shemel Shah is a gift too. Because there's so many men who prove that there's not a gift. That the Lord takes, Salakia, that the Lord takes the gift from you. Because they ain't in the door no more. Alright? Let me read this fifth verse. This is Psalms chapter 32, verse 5. Let's read this again. I acknowledge my sin unto thee. My iniquities have I not hid. I have said, I will confess my transgression unto thee, unto the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shah. And thou forgavest the iniquities of my sins, Salah. And that's what you hope for. And that's what you pray for. And in this time right now, what you're going through, when you're inflicting your soul. Because remember when Daniel did it, he did it for a certain amount of time, I can't remember the number, and he didn't eat for days. Can you imagine that? Just look at Yahweh Shah, he didn't eat for days. Just to inflict his soul. To build up the spirit between the spiritual bond between Yahweh Shemel, the Yahweh, between them and Yahweh. So this is this whole thing right now. This is the Day of Atonement. It's about getting a better relationship with Yahweh Shemel Shah and building your faith up, because that time is coming when we're gonna be out here with nothing. And if you don't have faith in Yahweh Shemel Shah, you're going to be destroyed. So that's what's coming. So this is practice makes perfect. Okay? This is what you're doing, practicing the righteous acts. Salakia, I hope I ain't all over the place, but let me read this verse again. I acknowledge my sin. And that's what you're doing right now. When you're afflicting your soul, you're acknowledging all the things you've done wrong, the Day of Atonement. Right? You pray to the Lord, Salakia. You tell him, you ask for forgiveness. You acknowledge, you confess your sins to him. Alright? I acknowledge my sins unto thee, and my iniquities I have not hid. I have said, I will confess my transgression. And we know what transgression means, right? Alright? I mean, sin upon sin. Alright? You've broken the law. Transgression means you've broken the law. Alright? To be rebellion. Okay? Alright? Unto the Lord Yahweh Shemel Shah. And thou hast forgiveth the iniquities of my sins a lot. Okay? And that's what we hope for. We hope that Yahweh Shemel Shah forgive us. And here's the point. Well, my point is that it's a lot. All right, it says right here, verse 6, Psalm chapter 32, verse 6. For this shall every man, everyone that is godly, pray unto thee in the time when thou mayest be found. Okay? Right now, when you were Yahweh Shemel Shah, y'all together, he found you, and you found him, and then how do you find him? By listening to the man of the Lord. And you better hope and pray Yahweh Shemel Shah give you that gift to understand. That's what we hope. When you fast, you're looking for more enhancement in understanding of Yahweh Shemel Shah. Okay? Surely, in the flood of a great water, they should not come nigh unto them, unto him. Now, this great water, could be a righteousness, or it could be the great flood of going through hell, of what is to come. Now, you don't want what is to come to drown you. You want righteousness to overflow with you and get you out of the way. But the hour of temptation is coming. And that flood is that military. They're gonna be out here. It's gonna be crazy out here in a minute. And you don't want to be in the mix of that. You want the Lord to carry you away from that madness. Because if you're godly, he's gonna protect you. You know? So, in this time, we are praying, in the Day of Atonement, we are praying to Yahweh Shemel Shah for forgiveness, and we're looking for him to hear us, to the spirit of Yahweh Shemel Shah. And if that's the case, the Day of Atonement is his day where he wants to hear you call on his name, do not feeding the flesh, but feeding the spirit. Because there's a war going on within you. Okay? Salaki, I hope that came out clear through the spirit of Yahba Shemel Shah. All prayers and honor and glory go to Yahba Shemel Shah, the Wadi Yahba Shemel Shah, for giving us the apostles and the elders a great millstone. We deserve double honors, rightfully so. And shalom to the Aki and pushing the word in sincerity and truth and being faith-based. Shalom.